keep it going for Kev and this whole situation. I'm a legend. I've been doing comedy long enough, and I ain't gonna make it. So, look at my motivation different. I flew out of my house to come to an undisclosed location. Nigga, this is, yeah, I know what I'm doing. Yeah. My motivation different. The rest of these comedians try to change the world with their laughter, and they might succeed. They got that fire in their eyes. I'm just here to get this money and get out of my arrears for child support. And I know y'all all want to talk about child support because it's a bad thing, or if you don't know what to do about it, I don't have no advice for you either. Just pay that shit. Like, pay that shit like a bill, on time and in full. Don't be emotional about it. That's where you get fucked up. I seen you emotional. I seen you down at family court, pacing back and forth in the hallway with your envelope full of receipts. Talking about wait till she hear my side of the story. She don't give a fuck about your side of the story. Pay that shit. I'm not your judge. You looking at a nigga that pay over $1,700 a month for child support. Yeah. Give me your basketball numbers. And I ain't saying my babies don't need that money. I ain't saying the pussy wasn't that good. You know what I'm saying? I'm saying it was $1,700 a month is a little bit steep for the rest of my life. You understand this? I know she's surprised when she get the check every month. She like, a bitch did something. This is crazy. So, needless to say, the normal shit don't matter to me. I'm just happy to be back out performing. We found out I was non-essential to the motherfucker during the pandemic. Yeah, I realized I had no life skills. I was like, this is all I could do. This is comedy. And a lot of y'all found out y'all was useless. Yeah. A lot of y'all thought y'all had good jobs till they hit you with that laptop. Like, just log on, you be all right. I just happened to live with somebody who was essential to the motherfucker. Yeah, my lady a nurse, frontline worker. So salute to the heroes as we needed them. That was dope, you know. But that immediately made me the nigga on the couch. Now, I've been the nigga on the couch, but I was the contributing nigga on the couch. Yeah, everybody ain't got the same look on their face. Shit get petty when you're not contributing, huh? Relationships is full of ups and downs. Arguments can be had. Shit get petty when you're not contributing. Things get said that can't be taken back. All of a sudden, my mom a bald head bitch. You understand? Like, shit get petty when you're not contributing. You know? Arguments you can't possibly win. Yeah. She hit me one the other day, fella. She came in from work. She was pissed, like, could you at least move from cushion to cushion on the couch? Stop crushing the same cushion, because we going to need a new couch soon. And I know you can't contribute. You understand? Right there. It was the last part that was petty and unnecessary. You understand? I was sliding down the couch when I heard her key in the door. I know how this go. Shit get petty when you're not contributing. I ain't seen shit I wanted to see on TV in months. You know how it is with your relationship. Sometimes you watch what you want to watch. Sometimes they watch what they want to watch. Sometimes y'all watch some stuff together. She rude about it. Snatched the remote out of my hand like I thought a nigga with no job wanted to watch something. She wasn't even watching the shit she turned to. Just me, you know. Watching 90 Day Fiancé for months. Shit get petty when you're not contributing. I had to learn how to eat loud food quiet. Because obviously the crunch was getting on her fucking nerves. Had a bag of Doritos the other day. Had to soak them bitches first. To get the crunch out. Needless to say, I'm happy to be here earning a buck. It's just different, man. And I know I look at things differently because I'm getting older. I look at time differently. Like I'm 49, I'm at that nap age. You know what I'm talking about? I'm at the age you can't be up all day long for no goddamn reason. Like certain point that I just gotta go lay down, like ain't nothing going on, let me go ahead. You know what I'm saying? The day get boring to me, I'm like, I'm gonna fucking check out. Wake back up, see what's popping when I wake up. And ain't nothing wrong with getting older. I know we all fight it, and I know young people don't want to hear that shit, but my grandmother's the one that gives me the wisdom on it. She's like, if you don't like getting older, you're going to hate the alternative. I was like, damn, that's a good one, Grandma. Then she gave me a better one. She's like, baby, you're going to have to figure out a way to age gracefully because you're not going to like everything that happens as you get older. When I was young, I couldn't hear her. But as I'm starting to get older, it's starting to come through a little clearer. You have to figure out a way to age gracefully. You're not going to like everything that happens as you get older. This ain't the haircut I wanted. This is the haircut they give you. You understand? I had dreams and aspirations. I want a little fro, maybe some cornrows. My barber stepped to me straight up like, look, ain't no need for you to keep coming around here. You understand? You come through and watch movies. Like, we all like talking to you. But... It's funny because my grandmother is who I talk to about getting older, but I hang out with my grandmother, and her to be 88 years old, I'm blessed to have her in my life. So I appreciate the times I spend with my grandmother. Go over, hang out, play cards, watch her favorite show, which is The Price is Right. That get a little annoying, though, because she's been alive so long, she know all the prices. So after a while, I'm like, all right, I ain't going to be sitting here all day with this shit because you know it all. Do whatever she want to do. I do whatever my grandma want to do. I don't let her take no naps, though. Not while I'm visiting. No, black people, you know what I'm saying. There's a difference between getting the phone call and sending them out. You know, when you get the phone call about Nana, it hurt, but you gotta take it. Shit. Grandma, all right, let's get together. You send them out, people got questions. Well, what happened? She went to sleep. Well, why you let her? Don't put that. Don't put that on me. I ain't know it's gonna be her last go to sleep. Like, she asked for a blanket. I thought I was doing her a favor. You know? Now, I don't know about y'all family, but I know my family ain't shit. I can hear my cousin put the phone down talking shit about me in the background. He talking about
she went to sleep.
You know, this nigga just came home from jail. He all suspicious with the big vocabulary. You know what I mean?
Oh, no, it's a lot of felonious assumptions.
This nigga turned my whole family against me. Nobody spoke to me at the funeral. I get down the front to pay my respects. My uncle snapped. This nigga killed grandma. I was like, yeah. I like y'all. Sometimes I tell that joke and people get tense. To the people that laughed, I appreciate your silliness. To the people that got tense, you need to stop being so tense or deal with that shit that's going on in your life. See, we didn't joke or laugh because it's a joke about mortality. Life or death, but pay attention. I told you up front, my grandmother's still alive. Number two, I'm talking about my grandmother. Seems like y'all got some unresolved issues. You call your aunt, stop bullshitting is what I'm saying. Point is, it's a joke about life or death, and we don't laugh at that like that makes a difference. Like death comes in a room. He'd be like, I didn't laugh. He'd be like, okay, I'll be back. No. Everybody going. Unfortunately, you only get one go round on this nice ride. Everybody going. Even the vegans. They act like they not going. You ever talk to them? Y'all fucking going too. They act like they not going. You shouldn't eat that. Why? Why? Because let's be real. That's the only way we going to know if any of the sacrifices you made, any of the changes you made work. Who died first? I tell you what. None of my vegan friends better go before me. Oh, I'm sure I bet your funeral act the fool. Dressed in all white, like, what happened? He dead? Not Mr. Green Smoothie. Get up, nigga. Look at all the vegans. Y'all going. I forgot Kev was vegan. He might not air this shit. Click! I don't know. Don't stop my stride, nigga. What are you doing? Nigga real in it, right? Is he? It's funny. Nigga, go win it. It's a comedy show. Is he? He was more upset that he didn't know. Is he? Why didn't I know this? different, man. And I know it, because I'm getting older and it's just different. I don't try as hard anymore. Especially when it comes to sex. Yeah, Lord, you young, you do that shit. I realized I was getting older when I heard a young man yell out some shit. He's like, I'm fucking all night. And I was like, why? My first thought wasn't, I wish I could hang out or where you going. My first thought was immediately, like, it get dark, like 7:30. Like, that's a long time. Like, I'm not for that. I'm at the age where I do the best I can. Because I've realized something as I've gotten older. I have a little bit more respect for women. Women got that thing called a vagina, and the vagina is a better weapon. Let's be honest, it can do amazing things like come again. You done came twice, fellas, but that wasn't two. That was one and one left over. You almost shot yourself, one in the chamber. You didn't know that was in there. Can't beat that vagina, man. That's a lifelong partnership. It's got their back. You could be 85 years old. You could be 85 years old. Vagina be like, look, if you see something you like, let me know. Give me a chance to get warmed up. We laughing and they laughing at us, fellas, because everybody in here know dick don't work like that. For that, you got to go back to 16. Remember him? 16-year-old dick was a monster. 16 was a terrorist. 16 couldn't be talked down or bargained with or reasoned. 16 didn't feel remorse or pity. 16 would spaz out anywhere like, I'ma shoot everybody. Yo, we had a funeral. They know me. 16 was disrespectful. Who mom is that? Can't do that when you get a little older. 40 ain't like that. 40-year-old dick ain't like that. You can't run up on 40-year-old dick unannounced willy-nilly on a Friday night. Like, yo, dick, I got one. 40-year-old dick be like, tonight? Wish you'd have called me sooner. I like to sleep in on Fridays, man. Gentlemen, all I do is suggest things to you. Have sex how you can win. That's all I can do. Have sex how you can win. I have sex in the dark with the fan on. I'm 40 plus. I need some air on my back. I don't know what the fuck that is. I could be outside in the snow. I'd be like, turn the air on. I need some air on my back. And no distractions. Slightest thing throw me off. Let that TV remote hit the floor. Well, that sound like a gun. Alexa, stop. The noises we making gonna have to be the music. And kill that TV, gentlemen. TV will hurt your feelings. But depending upon what's on, you know. Infomercials are cool. They loop. You don't really know how much time went by. Air fryer, pressure cooker. Could be 3 hours, could be 8 days. I made the mistake of having sex to an episode of Law & Order. To all my Law & Order fans out there, you know we move from segment to segment with doom doom. I made it past the first doom doom. The second doom doom, it was over. I'm slobbering on her chest, about to go to sleep. Before my eyes close, I look up at the TV screen and realize I ain't even make it to trial. I'm still at the precinct. Ice-T was like, we know what you did. I was like, yeah. Party people, my name is Touré, man. Have a good one.
One more time for two.